Hi, I'm Tim Viavant. I'm a fisheries biologist with the Alaska Department of Fish and Game. We're down here on the Copper River at Chitina on a typical rainy, windy day, dip netting for salmon. And today I'm going to talk about how to drift fish a dip net from a boat. Drift dip netting from a boat has a lot of advantages over fishing from shore. It can be a really productive way to fish. You have to have a boat, obviously, but if you do have one, it allows you to get to different places in the river, to fish places where you can't fish without a boat, and fishing can be really productive. You can catch a lot of fish in a short amount of time. So there are two places to launch a boat into the Copper River at Chitina. You can launch at the McCarthy Road Bridge on the east bank, and some people launch just downstream of the bridge. You can access this spot from the campground road within the highway easement. You can also launch just upstream of the bridge, and most people launch at that site because it's the most reliable and there's a public easement between the highway and the river. The other place to launch is at O'Brien Creek. However, the O'Brien Creek site is not always usable because of water levels, and if you do decide to launch at O'Brien Creek, you'll have to pay the Chitina Native Corporation an access fee to cross their land. No matter where you're going to launch, you'll need to have four-wheel drive because you're launching straight off of a gravel bar and there are no improved boat launches at Chitina. The Copper River is really challenging boat driving, especially through Wood Canyon. It's usually very windy and choppy, and that makes the water difficult to read. There's a lot of braided channels and gravel bars. So if you're planning on boating at Chitina, you should only use a boat with enough horsepower and with high enough sides to handle the water. So I'd like to talk a little bit about equipment. While you can drift fish any kind of dip net from a boat, these big square D-framed heads seem to work the best. I think they work the best because this long flat surface is fishing right along the bottom of the river, and that's where salmon tend to swim upstream. Because you're fishing your dip net right along the bottom, the rocks tend to wear the mesh out, and so I always take a piece of tubing and slit it lengthwise and cover that mesh up over the bottom of the frame. The other thing you want your dip net to have is on the handle somewhere, you need like a D handle like this or some other way of telling which direction the head is pointed in the current. You'll also need to have Lucky Fish Whopper stick, scissors to clip the fins, a cooler to keep your fish in. Also, whenever you're dip netting at Chitina, you need to have your sport fishing license and your personal use fishing permit on your person at all times. Also, since you're fishing out of a boat, you should always be wearing a PFD. So let's go do some fishing. There's three things that need to be happening while your dip net is drifting in the water. You need to keep the dip net head perpendicular to the current so that you're exposing as much of the netting to the fish swimming upriver as you can. You need to fish your dip net right along the bottom because salmon swim upstream right along the bottom. And you need your dip net head moving slightly faster than the current so that the mesh stays bagged out on the upstream side. This way, when a fish swims inside the mesh, when you feel it bump and you lift your net up, it's trapped inside the mesh. And remember, regulations require you to clip both lobes of the tail fin before leaving the fishing site. Different boats tend to fish differently. People with propeller boats tend to fish drifting downstream under power with the stern of the boat facing downstream. People with jet boats seem to fish floating with the boat sideways, but you're always fishing with the boat under power because it's the only way to control which direction the boat is facing in the river. The boat driver plays a really important role in how well a boat is drifting and fishing. The boat driver's job is to keep the boat pointed in the same direction and moving a little bit faster than the current. This allows the dip netters to do their job, which is fishing, without having to pay attention to what direction the boat's facing and how fast it's going. Some people try to fish and drive the boat at the same time. This usually doesn't work very well because the boat driver has to pay constant attention to where the boat's pointed and how fast it's going. And if you're trying to fish, you can't do both things at once.
You usually drift fish in sections of the river where it's not too deep, where the bottom is fairly flat and even, and you want a substrate of sand or gravel. You also fish in places where you've fished before or you've seen people fishing so that you know it's safe to fish there without snagging an expensive dip net on a boulder and losing it.
When you feel a fish hit your net, pull the net up vertically out of the water. Don't try to scoop the fish up in the net because you can't move the net through the water fast enough and fish will have time to back out of your dip net. When you do lift your net out of the water, remember, there's 12 feet of handle that you have to control and keep track of, or you'll end up hitting other people in the boat or possibly even knocking them overboard. Don't fish hanging out of the boat like this. You never know when a big king salmon will hit your net, and falling into the Copper River could be deadly. When you're finished fishing, you're required by law to fill out your permit and record your catch before you leave the fishing site. Since you're fishing on the river, I'd recommend filling it out as soon as you get to shore. You need to record the number of fish you caught by species and the date. So I hope you find this information useful, and good luck fishing for salmon on the Copper River. Hopefully, you'll catch a lot of these.